The man of walk through their perfection, shall be my friend.
No man who practices deceit shall live within my house.
No man who utters lies shall stand before my eyes.
No man who shall silence all the wicked in my land.
Uprooting from the city of the Lord all who do evil.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God.
Glory to you, O God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The man, glory of the righteous, is celebrated with praise. But for you, O for all your Lord's testimony is enough. You were shown to be more honorable than the prophets, since you were being permitted to baptize in the water of the Lord, you could have profaned. Therefore, you fought for the truth, and with joy proclaimed the news to those in divinity. That God has appeared in the flesh to take away the sins of the world and to grant us great mercy. Now and ever and forever, amen. What shall we call? What shall we call you, Lord, full of grace? On earth, for you have born a son of justice. On paradise, we have but for the flower of immortality. A virgin, for you have remained undefiled. A mother, holding her boy, and the son who is the God of all. In the sea with him for the salvation of our souls. Guide my footsteps according to your promise, and let no iniquity rule over me.
Redeem me from man's oppression, I shall keep your precepts. Let your face shine on your servant, and teach me your decrees.
My mouth is filled with your praise, O Lord, that I may sing your glory all the day long.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen.
Blessed be the mercy on us, Lord, Jesus, for our sins, Master, forgive our transgressions. Holy One, come to us and learn from these for your name's sake.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
The Virgin, who once was barren, gives birth to Christ for all. He himself is the fulfillment of all prophecy. For in the judgment he was his hand. Upon the word of the tongue of prophets had foretold, and was shown to be his prophet, herald, and Lord of the Lord. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Yarra the Ham, 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 Yarra the Ham,
O good God, in all times and places you are worshipped and glorified both in heaven and on earth. You are long-suffering and generous in your mercy and compassion. You love the just and show mercy to the sinner, calling all to repentance through the promise of blessings to come. Deem, O Lord, at this very hour to receive our supplications and to direct our lives in the path of your commandments. Sanctify our souls, purify our bodies, set the right our minds, cleanse our thoughts. Deliver us from all affliction, trouble, and distress. Surround us with your holy angels, so that guided and guarded in their camp, we may attain oneness of faith and the knowledge of your unspeakable glory. For you are blessed forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen.
More honorable than the cherubim, and beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim, the Virgin gave birth to God, the Word. You truly the faith of us be magnified.
Give the blessing, Father, in the name of the Lord.
May God be merciful to us and bless us. May he cause his countenance to shine upon us and have mercy on us.
Amen.
O Christ, you are the true light who enlightens and sanctifies everyone coming into the world. Sign us with the light of your face, that walking in it we may see the light of your unapproachable glory. Direct our steps in the observance of your commands, through the prayers of your most pure Mother and of all your saints.
Amen.
Come, let us worship our King and God.
Come, let us worship Christ, our King and God.
Come, let us worship and bow before the only Lord Jesus Christ, the King and our God.
Lord, your God, this joyous day is to my cross.
Turn your ear to my prayer, and holy seed is on my lips. You search my heart, you visit me by night, you test me by fire, and you find in me no wrong. My words are not sinful like men's words.
I get from violence with your word, I get my feet firmly in your wrath, there is no faltering in my soul.
I am here and I call, you will hear me, O God, turn your ears to me, hear my word. Guard me as the apple of your eye, hide me in the shadow of your wings, from the violent attack of the wicked. Their eyes are watching to strike me to the ground, as though they were lions ready to claw, but like some young lion crouched in my knee.
Let your hand, O Lord,
rescue me from them, from them as rewards in this present life. As for me in my justice, I shall see your face, and be filled when I awake from the sight of your glory.
You, Lord, my soul, I trust you, let me not be disappointed, do not let my enemies fall.
Those who hope in you shall not be disappointed, but only those who want to believe great faith.
Lord, make me know your ways, so teach me your path.
Make me walk in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior.
Enjoy it all day long, remember your mercy, Lord, and the love you have shown from all.
Do not remember the sins of my youth, but remember me according to your mercy, because of your goodness, O Lord.
The Lord is good and upright, he will give laws to those who stray.
He guides the humble in the right path, he teaches his way to the poor. Lord, for the sake of your name, forgive my guilt, for it is great. His soul will dwell among the good, his children shall possess the land. My eyes are always on the Lord, for he rescues my feet from the snare. The afflictions of my heart are multiplied, set me free from my distress. See how many are my foes, how violent their hatred for me.
Preserve my life
Ministers and uprightness protect me, for my hope is in you, O Lord, redeem Israel, O God, from all this distress. O wash me more and more from my guilt, and cleanse me from my sin. Against you, you alone have I sinned. What is evil in your sight I have done? O see and guilt I was born, a sinner was I conceived.
Indeed, you love truth in the heart, and the secret of my heart teach me wisdom.
Sprinkle me with hyssop, then I shall be clean. O wash me, I shall be white and snow.
Make me your joys and gladness, the one you crush my fill.
From my sins turn away your face, and blot out all my guilt.
Put your heart within your God, to set that spirit within me.
Do not cast me away from your presence, nor deprive me of your Holy Spirit.
Give me again the joy of your help, and the spirit of your Lord sustain me.
That I may teach transgressors your ways, and sinners may return to you.
Deliver me from the cares of God, my saving God, my downturn out of your goodness.
O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise.
For in sacrifice you take no delight, nor drop fruit from me with you.
I sacrifice a contrite spirit, with dry humble heart to the last bird.
In the goodness of the Lord shall make me Zion, and heal the walls of Jerusalem.
Then you will be pleased with all sacrifice, burnt offerings holy and soon. Then will be offering unto those on your altar.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, glory to you, O God.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy,
Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You shared in the apostles' way of life, and succeeded to their throne, divinely inspired bishop. You found access to contemplation in the active life. Therefore, you rightly brought the word of truth, and struggled for the faith to the shedding of your blood. All the priests wanted at Belius. Great Christ, our God, to save our souls. Now and ever and forever, amen. O fair, O Lord, of us, you are to thine, and you prove the truth of life. Wherefore we implore you, O Lady, to intercede together with the apostles and all the saints, that we may obtain mercy before our souls. May the Lord God be blessed, may the Lord be blessed day after day, the God of our salvation will prosper us. This God of ours is the God who saves.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and ever. Amen.
Most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, cleanse us from our sins, master from our transgressions. Holy One, come to us in your our infirmities for your name's sake.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
We all speak, God, in operation, you are the Holy One, splendor of victory. We beseech you, O priest martyred with endeavor from danger, on those who stand required of the remitter, intercede with unceasingly for all of us. O good God, in all times and places you are worshipped and glorified, both in heaven and on earth. You are long-suffering and generous in your mercy and compassion. You love the just and show mercy to the sinner, calling all to repentance through the promise of blessings to come. Deem, O Lord, in this very hour to receive our supplications and to direct our lives in the path of your commandments. Sanctify our souls, purify our bodies and our minds, cleanse our thoughts. Deliver us from all affliction, trouble, and distress. Surround us with your holy angels, so that guided and guarded in our camp, we may attain oneness of faith and the knowledge of your unspeakable glory. For you are blessed forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen.
More honorable than the cherubim and beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim, who a virgin gave birth to God the Word, you truly the fair of us be
magnified.
May God be merciful to us and bless us. May he cause his countenance to shine upon us and have mercy on us. Master and God, Almighty Father, only begotten Son, Lord Jesus Christ, and Holy Spirit, one divinity and one mind, have mercy on me, a sinner, and save me, your unworthy servant, according to the ways of your wisdom, for you are blessed forever and ever.
Amen.
Glory to you, O Christ, God, our hope, glory to you. May Christ, our true God, have mercy on us and save us through the prayers of his most pure mother, of the honorable and glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and illustrious apostles, of the holy proto-martyr and archdeacon Stephen, the patron of our church, of the holy martyr Eleutherius, of our venerable father Paul of Latra, of our holy father Stephen, bishop of Storoz, and through the prayers of all the saints, for Christ is good and loves us all. Glory to Jesus Christ. Slava Jesu Christu. For favorable weather, for for an abundance of the fruits of the earth and for peaceful times, let us praise the Lord. For those who travel by sea, air, and land, who mistake the suffering, the captive, and their salvation, let us praise the Lord. That we be delivered from all affliction, wrath, and need, let us praise the Lord. Protect us, save us, have mercy on us, and preserve us, O God, by your grace. Commemorating our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the death of God, and ever virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another in our whole lives to Christ our God. Lord our God, mighty beyond description, glorious above all understanding, merciful without limit, loving us all beyond expression, with the compassion on us, and on this holy church, O Master, and show us and those who pray with us the riches of your tender mercy. For through you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, is your glory, honor, and worship, now and ever and forever. forgiveness. When you were killed by stoning at the hands of sinners, you received the crown from God's right hand while you cried out, Lord, what will this sin against them? You shared in the apostles' way of life and succeeded to the throne. Divinely inspired bishop, you found access to contemplation in the active life. Therefore, you rightly taught the word of truth and struggled for the faith through the shedding of your blood. All priests, Marefarius, risen Christ our God to save our souls. You were numbered among the monks and a companion of angels, and so we raise this song to you, O glorious Paul. Pray that we may find mercy for our souls. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. We all sing, I give a praise to you, O Holy One, the splendor of bishops and an example of victory. We beseech you, O priest, martyr, to deliver from danger all those who celebrate our memory with fervor. Intercede unceasingly for all of us. Now and ever and forever, Amen. Steadfast protectress of Christians, unshakable mediatrix before the Creator, do not despise the prayerful voices of sinners, but in your goodness hurry to assist those who faithfully cry out to you. Hasten to intercede and meet our supplication, interceding always and always in behalf of those who honor you. For you are holy, our God, and we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Now and ever and forever, Amen. Holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Let us be attentive. Peace be to all, wisdom be attentive, rejoice in glory, rejoice in glory, shout out for joy and sing to the Lord a new song of praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let the faithful rejoice in glory. Rejoice in glory. Shout for joy and thankfulness. Wisdom, a reading from the Epistle to the Hebrews. Let us be attentive, brethren. Therefore, when his rest remains. Let us fear, lest any of you be judged to have failed to reach it. For good news came to us just as to them, but the message which they heard did not benefit them, because it did not meet with faith in the hearers. For we who have believed unto that rest, as he has said, as I swore in my wrath, they shall never enter my rest. Although his works were finished from the foundation of the world, for he hath somewhere spoken of the seventh day in this way, and God rested on the seventh day from all his works. And again in this place he said, they shall never enter into my rest. Since therefore it remains for some to enter it, and those who formerly received the good news failed to enter because of disobedience, again he sets a certain day. Today, saying through David so long afterward in the words already quoted, today when you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts. For if Joshua had given them rest, God would not speak later of another day. So then, there remains a Sabbath rest for the people of God. For whoever enters God's rest also ceases from his labors as God did from his. Let us therefore strive to enter that rest, that no one fall by the same sort of disobedience. For the word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing to the division of soul and spirit, of joints and marrow, and discerning the thoughts and intentions of the heart. And before him no creature is hidden, but all are open and laid bare to the eyes of him with whom we have to do. Wisdom, be attentive. Alleluia. Trees. Then a second time Jesus laid hands on his eyes, and he saw perfectly. His sight was restored, and he could see everything clearly. Jesus sent him home with the admonition, do not even go into the village. let us all say with our whole soul and with our whole mind, let us say. O Lord, Almighty God, our fathers, we pray you hear and have mercy. Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray you hear and have mercy. Again, we pray for our holy Father Francis, Pope of Rome, and for our most reverend Metropolitan William, for those who serve and have, for our godly Bishop Milan, for those who serve and have served in this holy church, for our spiritual fathers, and for all our brothers and sisters in Christ.
Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for our government and for all in the service of our country. Again, we pray you, O Lord our God, hear our supplication and hear your grace and mercy on your servant, the Mancade, grant all his petitions. And pardon all his voluntary and involuntary sins. Accept his supplications and charitable deeds before the throne of your majesty. Safeguard him from every visible and invisible enemy, from every misfortune, distress, and affliction. Spare him from illness and grant him health and long life. Let us all say, O Lord, hear and have mercy. Loving Lord, look down with merciful eyes upon your servant, the Mancade, and hear the supplication that we have offered up with faith. For you yourself have said, believe that you will receive whatever you ask for in prayer, and it will be yours. You also said, ask and you will receive. Because of this unworthy as we are, we trust in your mercy and ask that you be merciful to your servant, the Mancade, and fulfill his good desires. Keep him in peace, tranquility, and health, and grant him long life. Let us all say, O Lord, hear and graciously have mercy. Again, we pray that we clear present to await your great and abundant mercy for those who show us mercy and for all Christians of the true faith. For you are a merciful and loving God, and we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Thank you. Son, whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and forever. Peace be to all. Let us love one another, that with one mind we may prove
Son and your Holy Spirit. Holy are you and all holy and
glory. You so loved your world that you gave your only begotten Son, so that anyone who believes in him should not perish, but have life everlasting. He came and fulfilled the whole divine plan in our behalf. On the night he was betrayed or rather when he surrendered himself for the life of the world, he took bread and his holy of your immaculate hands, gave thanks and blessed, sanctified, broke, and gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, take heed, this is my body, which is broken for you, for the remission of sins. Likewise, he took the chalice after supper, saying, drink of this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the remission of sins. Remembering therefore this saving command and all that has come to pass in our behalf, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection on the third day, the ascension into heaven, sitting at the right hand, and the second coming in glory, offering you your own from your own, always and everywhere. We praise you, we bless you, we thank you, O Lord, and we pray to you, our God. Moreover, we offer to you this spiritual and unbody sacrifice, and we implore and entreat you to send down your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts lying before us, and make this bread the precious body of your Christ, and that which is in this chalice the precious blood of your Christ, changing them by your Holy Spirit, that for those who partake of them, they may bring about a spirit of vigilance, the remission of sins, the communion of your Holy Spirit, the fullness of the heavenly kingdom and confidence in you, not judgment nor condemnation. Moreover, we offer the spiritual sacrifice for those who pardon and change, the forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and worthy of spiritual protection, especially for our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Lamb of hosts and ever virgin Mary. We further offer the spiritual sacrifice for the whole world, for the Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, for those who live in purity and holiness, for our government and all in the service of our country. Let them govern in peace, O Lord, and in that tranquility we may lead a calm and quiet life in all piety and holy gods. Among the first, O Lord, remember our holy Pope Francis, Pope of Rome, our most reverend Metropolitan William, our God-loving Bishop Milan. Preserve them for your holy churches in peace, safety, honor, and health, for many years as they faithfully impart the word of your truth. Remember, O Lord, the city in which we dwell, every city and community and the faithful living in them. Remember, O Lord, those who travel by sea, air, and land, the sick, the suffering, the captive, and friends of salvation. Remember, O Lord, those who bring offerings and perform good deeds in your holy churches, and those who remember the poor, and follow us and down your mercies. And grant that with one voice and one heart we may glorify and praise your most honored and magnificent name. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. May the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you.
And with
Now that we have commemorated all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts offered and consecrated that our God loves us all, may receive them on his holy and invisible altar as an aroma of spiritual fragrance, and send out the hearts and return his divine grace, and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray. That we be delivered from all affliction, wrath, and need, let us pray to the Lord. Protect us, save us, have mercy on us, and preserve us, O God, by your grace. That this whole day be perfect, holy, peaceful, and without sin, let us beseech the Lord. For an angel of peace and faith to God and guardian of our souls and bodies, let us beseech the Lord. For the pardon and remission of our sins and all offenses, let us beseech the Lord. For what is good and beneficial to our souls and for peace in the world, let us beseech the Lord. That we may spend the rest of our life in peace and repentance, let us beseech the Lord. For a Christian, painless, unashamed, peaceful end of our life, and for a good account for the fearsome judgment seat of Christ, let us beseech the Lord. Asking for unity in the faith and for communion in the Holy Spirit, let us commit ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God. To you, O Master, who love us all, we commit our whole life and hope and we implore, pray, and entreat you. Make us worthy to partake with a clear conscience of your heavenly and awesome mysteries from this sacred and spiritual table. May they bring about the remission of sins, the pardon of transgressions, the communion of the Holy Spirit, the inheritance of the kingdom of heaven, confidence in you, not judgment or condemnation, and make us worthy, O Master, that we may with confidence and without condemnation, dare call you Father, God of heaven, and say, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Peace be to all. Bow your heads to the Lord. We give you thanks, O invisible King, for your immeasurable power, you have fashioned all things, and in the greatness of your mercy, have brought all things out of non-existence into being. Look down, remember, Master, upon those of our heads, to you, that they did not bow to flesh and blood, but to you, the awesome God. Therefore, O Master, make smooth for the good of all the path that lies ahead, according to the need of each. Sail those who sail, travel those who travel, cure those who are sick, O physician, souls and bodies, through the grace, the mercies, and the loving kindness of your only begotten Son, whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever and forever. Let us be attentive, holy gifts to holy people. Approach with fear of God and with faith. Thank you. righteousness has touched your lips and will take away your iniquities and cleanse your sins. Save your people, O God, and bless your inheritance. Blessed is our God, all is now and ever and forever. May Christ, our true God, have mercy on us and save us through the prayers of his most pure Mother, of the holy, glorious, and illustrious apostles, of our holy Father John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, of the holy Protomartyr and Archdeacon Stephen, the patron of our church, of the holy martyr Eleftherius, of our venerable father Paul of Latra, of our holy father Stephen, and through the prayers of all the saints, for Christ is good and loves us all. Glory to Jesus Christ. Lovely Susan Christian. To your servant of all time, grant the Lord many years. Oh, grant me many years.
happiness in health and happiness. God grant him happy. Blessed be.
Thank you.